Screen share and let me show you how this tool will for you. Okay, well, I've opened a structural template here. Let me put the unit on meter to work properly. I'm okay with meter. You can work with whichever unit you want. It doesn't make any difference. We want to create some. I want to create some straight tunnel here, or you can create some water channels. It depends on your project. I'm going to use modeling place tools to create that. Put it on a structural categories to be able to create a rebar for them. You can use a structural column or anything you want, but I'm going to use a structural framing here. It doesn't make any difference. And let me put it on tunnel, press on OK, and then let me create an extrusion here. Let me create a reference line here, and then let's set our work plane on this reference line here. Press tab, and now let's see the work plane. We are in this work plane, and now we can create a extrusion for we can create a profile for our tunnel. You go to the extrusion tool, and from here let's create a. I'm not going to work very proper with numbers because it's a tutorial, so I'm not going to choose any numbers, and I'm working with just some. We can say I'm eyeballing this, so. This is not a good idea here. Let me create a center line for this tunnel, and let me put the highest place to maybe here or maybe less, and let's create a curve here. Let me make this one a little bit shorter, and let's create a curve here, and let's use mirror, press MM, and mirror this one to here. I don't need this anymore, and also I can't continue this arc to have less lines here, and makes your model more optimized. And then let me measure this height here. It is about 70 centimeters. So go to the pick line tool and create a 70 offset, and it will create a shell for your tunnel. Okay, this is great. Let me draw a line here and also here too, and then use trim to make a loop and close area here. Okay, this is great. Click on finish and make it a little bit bigger, and this is the shape that we are going to work for here. Let me assign a concrete material to it. This is great. Click on OK, click on finish, and in here we are good to go to create some rebar for this complex shape and unusual shape. Very easy. You just need to select your solid form, and then click on rebar, click on OK, and now you can see we are on freeform mode, and we have two methods. We have align and we have surface. These are some they will work differently in each places, so you need to exercise them to master them. I will do examples for both of them to familiarize you with the work that they can do for us. For this one, I'm going to create a rebar for this surface with this kind of shape. So we need to first of all, as you can see, the text shows us near my cursor. You can see it's Revit ask us to go select the host surfaces. So let's choose the host surfaces. I'm pressing the control button to be able to select multiple host surfaces. You can choose one too, but for this purpose, as my purpose, I need to select multiple surfaces. And then after selecting your hard surfaces, you need to press space button on your keyboard, and then you need to select your start surface, which in this scenario, this is the start surface, and press space again. You need to select your end surface, and then you are good to go. It is better to press space another time, and you can see we are in the first step, but don't worry, it is okay, and you just need to press finish here to have the rebar. And as you can see, we have the rebar here. Let me put the visual style on wireframe. As you can see, we have this great rebar here, and we can adjust the hooks, we can adjust some numbers here. It is really easy to do that, so I'm not going to explain all of these tools because it's not, it is a general setting for all of the reinforcements. Okay, let me put this to multiple sets of rebars. Let me put it on maximum spacing, and let me put it on about 30 centimeter or 300 millimeter, and just can see Revit will create your rebars very easily. Select all of them and let me make them solid in 3D view. Also, I'm going to see them obscured, unobscured too. Let's go to the shaded mode. As you can see, we have these great things here. And if you are worried about the cover and something like that, you can work with concert. Let me override a color for this to see it better. Okay, that's okay. Let me make these three bars a little bit bigger, maybe about 32 millimeter for diameters. It will make your computer slow. It is obvious because these are some big shapes. Okay, let's create another one for the bottom face of this. Okay, select the shape again, press rebar, and you need to select these faces this time. So it's all about selecting the right faces. Okay, this is enough for me. Press space and then select your start face, press space again, and then select your end face and press space again. And then last step is you need to press click on finish here, and now you have the bottom part of your rebars too. And then let me put it on maximum spacing, and let me adjust it to 30 centimeter, and we are good to go. And also let me make them solid too. Let me override them too. Okay, it is great, but in some scenarios for some rebars, we need to do that in another method. For example, I'm going to create some perpendicular reinforcement to in here like this. Let me show you in the left side. I'm going to create some rebars, straight rebars in here, in bottom of this rebars, and I'm going to put them in a straight. So for this scenario, I'm going to use the align method. Select your shape, click on rebar, and then select the align method. This time the hard surface is the exact one like the previous times, because I'm not going to I can create these straight rebars here easily with just sketch rebars. I'm not going to select these surfaces too, because it makes it a little bit complicated and sometimes it doesn't respond. So select this one, press space on your keyboard, and then for the pass you need to select this one and press space, and then click on finish. You can see we have a straight rebar here. Also, we can make it multiples. Let me put it on maximum spacing, and let me put it on about 35 centimeter. And then let me make them 3D, and like let's see them. We are solid. You can see them here. These are they are so small. So let me make them bigger. And these are in clash with this other and horizontal rebar. So you need to go to the edit constraint, and from here I think it's gonna be minus. Okay, let's go to the left part. It is a little bit too much. Let me put it on about maybe 4 centimeter. Okay, it is great. And then click on finish and you are good to go. And also we need to create some other exact shape for the bottom face. So choose your shape again, go to the rebar, and from here use the align method, and this time select the bottom face, not the top face. It's not the one that I want. Press tab. This is the right one. You can see here, press space on your keyboard, and then choose this path, press space again, and then click on finish, and you have the rebar here. Let me put it on maximum spacing, and let me put it on 35 centimeter, and then let's us to make them solid in this view, and also let's make them bigger to 32. You can see them here. The last step is to work with the edit constraint here. This time it is minus again, so put it on minus 4 centimeter, and you can see they don't have any clashes this time. Also, it's okay. You can make it a little bit smaller to lay it accurately on the other rebars. So it is okay, and let me make them in another color to see it better in this situation. You can see we've made these rebars very easily with this great tool. You can create some things for here with very easily with a sketch rebar, so it's not a big problem. You just need to select this, and you can create some rebars in here. So I'm not going to create them here. The main goal was the freeform rebar. As you see, sometimes you need to use align method, and sometimes you need to